All right, Pisces, let's do a What's the Tea reading. We haven't done one of these in a little bit. So let's see, for the sign of Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, North Node, and Jupiter. Let's see what messages come through for you. Today is September 6th, so let's do for the next 72 hours. I'm going to get back on the next 72 hours. And I'm going to start doing all signs day. So now that, you know, school has started back up, I'll have a little bit more time. Alright, so let's see. Messages, please, for Pisces. What do we got for Pisces? What is the day that Pisces may need to know about for the next 72 hours? Five cards, please. Five cards. Single jumping cards. We got idol. Loved, respected, admired, idolized, and fan and into you. Ooh. Someone's got... This came up in yesterday's reading. The secret admirer energy. This could be the same one. All right. So you got into you. I'm so into you. Good chemistry, great vibes, and positive. So somebody may be like, idolizing you, or you may be idolizing someone else. You may be into somebody who could be someone in the public eye or someone who, you know, may have a following of some sort. Some of you guys could be crushing on someone. Someone could be crushing on you. All right. What else? What is the tea for Pisces? We got moving on. Thank you. Next. And love triangle. Okay. Okay. And fishing for comments. All right. So some of you guys are moving on from some type of a third party situation. Okay. Some type of a love triangle. Third party, multiple lovers and choices. Okay. Moving on. Thank you. Next. Some of you guys may have, you know, recently found out that someone here put you in a third party. You may find out that... Love triangle. I don't know. Fishing for comments. Some of you guys could have, you know... I don't know. If you guys were looking and you went snooping, you seen something, or someone else is looking for comments, trying to get someone's attention, someone here could be... let's see. Give me one more. Creeping. Yeah, someone's looking... Like I was thinking, someone here is looking for comments. Okay. It's going to be someone who's always partying. Someone could be hating on someone's spirituality, hating on whatever. Okay. So let's see. Why does this light keep going out? Stop it. All right. So what is this idol? Loved, respected, admired, idolized, and fan. Why is this here? Pisces. Who that? Who that? Who that? I thought you knew that. Knew that. I sang that song yesterday. Alright, so let's see. What's this idol for Pisces, please? Idol. I think I just seen the Hierophant. Taurus energy. Eight of Cups reversed. Hierophant, Knight of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sag, Hierophant, dang, okay, idol. So someone here could be rushing in, coming in hot and heavy, hot and ready, like Little Caesar's Pizza, JK, okay. Damn. Someone could be rushing in for some type of commitment. This could be, I could read this two ways, but let's see. Eight of Cups in the reverse, Three Swords on the bottom. Someone here may be feeling this for Queen of Swords. Some of you guys, this could be an ex of yours. I'm also seeing glow up energy, Ten of Pentacles and the Sun card. Someone here may have had a glow up, Temperance. Damn, that came out in last reading too. The Sun and Temperance. Ten of Pentacles here. So someone may have had some type of a glow up. Okay. And I don't know if there's someone here who maybe you're divorced from, you're separated from, who could be feeling heartbroken about a situation. That could be who's returning. Y'all keep in mind, we are in Mercury retrograde till September 14th. Okay, good. But then there's still, you know, some after shadow phase. So I would say to be in the clear, wait till October. I mean, it's up to you. Do whatever you want to do, but, you know, just know things tend to, you know, you jump into any type of contracts, commitments, take exes back, or even, I don't even want to say take them back, but whatever goes on during Mercury retrograde, you know, runs the chance of it being dismantled when it goes direct, okay? So if you sign any type of major contracts, paperwork, you know, communications could get communications could get messed up, you know, emails could get lost, phone calls could get dropped, maybe messages don't come through, stuff like that, miscommunication. Also, with the energy surrounding Mercury retrograde, oftentimes it tends to kind of like bring up a lot of past memories, emotions, good or bad, you know. So if you find yourself pining in your thoughts, you know, more than usual or just at all, it could be due to the planetary involvement. So a lot of times exes will be like, oh, I miss my ex. We did have such a good time together and blah, blah, blah. And then they like reach out to that ex and then they end up getting back together and they're like, oh, everything's great. And then Mercury goes direct and then they wake up and they're like, why am I here? Like, I can't stand you, you know? And I'm being a little extreme, but ultimately that's just like the quick version of the scenario, okay, of what Mercury retrograde can do, all right? But it is very true, so y'all can try it if you want to. I know I have. This shit's funny. Okay, it's funny now because I've already, like, gone through it, thought I could beat it, and I was like, oh, if the other person doesn't know about it, then, you know, let me try, you know? Nah. I think that was a lesson for me spiritually, like, in order to tell you guys, you know? I had to try it first. Definitely on the day Mercury went direct, my whole shit, my whole fantasy was fucking blown. Like, stuck a fucking grenade in it and just poof, just blew that shit up. I'm telling you, the day, I won't forget, I think it was June 16th or June 22nd. I don't know. I forget now because it's been a while, but true story. So anyways, back to your reading. If you do have someone coming back from the past, rushing in, hot and heavy, all passionate, like, oh, baby, baby, I want to be in a commitment. Just know. Their emotions is backwards right now. Literally, Eight of Cups in the reverse. They may really want you until that shit hits direct. And then they're going to be like, ugh. Or you will. One or the other. All right, Queen of Cups. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Could be speaking to a feminine here. This could be someone returning to a baby's mom, a mother figure, or someone who's very intuitive, caring, kind, nurturing man. This could be you too. It doesn't have to be a woman. It's just a feminine energy, okay? I do feel like there is someone here who's very divinely connected to Source. Someone here who could, you know, this Queen of Cups could also be a teacher. Whoever this is, it's rushing in. This is someone who's either you've already walked away from or someone who's walked away from you emotionally, okay? Someone where there's already been a disconnect and somebody's returning. But again, like I was just explaining, so with this idolized, loved, respected, admired, idolized, and fan, you know, someone may be seeing somebody in very high regard, but they're coming in as a Knight of Wands, okay? That's kind of flighty. It's a flight risk. This person's a flight risk. If this is already someone who's walked away from you already, what's going to keep them from walking away during Mercury retrograde? Or at all, period. Doesn't even matter. I mean, it does matter, but I'm just trying to make a point. But anyways, I do feel like someone sees you in high regard, but you also need to see yourself in high regard, okay? And not accept this shit. Somebody coming in all passionate, lustful, flirty. This person could be very attractive, okay? Very energetic. You know, the Knight of Wands in the upright is someone who's a daredevil. They're very, they've got like an electrifying type of energy. So this could be someone who moves very fast, talks very fast, you know, flirty, fun, exciting. Okay, it's like that whirlwind type energy. And if you're someone who's very, you know, content, peaceful, something here could even be a spiritual lesson as well. Mm-hmm. With the Queen of Cups to this Eight of Cups reverse, I feel like you've already turned your back on this situation, or you will, or, you know, there's someone who did that to you. Anyways, moving on. Into you. Ah! No. Could be a Capricorn. Okay. Some of you guys may have a Capricorn that's into you. Fuck. Okay. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling good. All right. So let's see. The Devil. All right. Into you. Someone could be obsessed. Damn. Knight of Cups. Ugh. Whoever this is, this person could be extremely charming. Like, sweep you off your feet. Just throw you in the fire pits of hell. Just joking. Okay. I'm trying to, like, lighten the mood, but... Y'all, into you. This could just be someone obsessed with you, but they're still coming in as a knight. If this is the same person, Devil and the Knight of Cups, it's like this person may be like so romantic, like so charming. Like this person is gonna be a temptation with the Devil here. Like, damn. You wanna go where? You wanna do what? Oh, that sounds really nice. But what's that song? I don't know. Something about one. Oh, I think I know what song it is. That's fucked up. It's by Little Mix, I think is the name of it. It's called Black Magic. Give me 1 second. Okay, so I had to look up the song. It's actually kind of a cute song if you take it in a lighthearted way. Because this shit is like actually real. You know, like people do this shit and bend people's free will, but the video makes it seem like it's cute and innocent, I guess. But anyways, so the lyrics I was hearing is, hopefully I don't get copyrighted for this, but take a sip from a secret potion. I'll make you fall in love. Oh, shit. Oh, shit, y'all. Let's keep going. Show me into you. Nine of Wands. Saggy energy. Ooh, the World. This is giving me like, this is giving me someone here feels defeated over some type of an ending, a cycle being closed out. Someone here feels like the wounded warrior, but with the Nine of Wands, it's like someone still has that little extra oomph to get up and keep it going. Okay. But the cycle is already something that looks like it's closed out. Okay. But this is like, that could be why somebody's going to like desperate measures. Take a sip from a secret potion. I'll make you fall in love from a something that can't be broken. One drop should be enough. Yeah. Okay. Somebody may be coming in feeling like desperate, like this is my last chance. But the energy here is like someone feels defeated over an ending, whether it's an ending in their own life or an ending with you. This is someone who feels like they want to keep fighting for something that's already done. Signed, sealed, delivered. Moving on. Thank you. Next. All right. Let's keep going. Show me moving on. Thank you. Next. Seven of Wands, blocking. Okay, standing your ground, setting up boundaries, moving on, thinking next. Page of Pentacles came out in the reverse, so no new opportunities. Eight of Swords. Some of you guys could be blocking messages, okay, with the Seven of Wands, Page of Pentacles in the reverse. You're not accepting anything from somebody. One more. Chariot. No, it's like someone's moving on, determined to move past this. I feel like somebody here is trapped in their thoughts, trapped in their mind. They could feel like they missed an opportunity. This can even be spirit blocking this connection or blocking messages retrograde, like I was already explaining earlier. Seven of Wands can sometimes be a spiritual block. Something here could be backfiring. Someone else may be in their head, feeling stuck, trapped, and bound. Chariot, Cancerian energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn is here. Show me love triangle. Whatever this is, I feel like the Chariot is like, it's a major arcana. The Eight of Swords is a minor. So it's like, whatever this is, there could be some type of mental confliction here. I don't know. I want to clarify that. But either way, the Chariot is major arcana. It's determination and willpower. It's like, it's the fastest moving card in the deck. So some of you guys are like, by all means necessary, I will move out of whatever this is. Or someone could even be experiencing like some type of blocks when it comes to travel. Messages. It's like someone maybe keep trying to do different things, but each time they keep getting blocked. Or hitting some type of a block. And you see there's two blocks in front of this Chariot as well. Show me love. Show me this Eight of Swords. The Star in the reverse. Star in the reverse is losing hope, you know. Eight of Swords, damn. Aquarius energy. I don't know if this is you or someone else, but someone here has like lost all hope in a situation. Someone's heavily in their thoughts, feeling stuck. Backed into a corner, blocked. Then give me one on the Chariot. The Queen of Swords, or a King of Swords, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Yeah, someone's like, for some, this could be an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini coming in. This could be this ex person that's determined. What's the King of Swords? Someone may be trying to... Eight of Pentacles. I don't know. If someone here is saying I want to work on something, or someone here is like, someone's telling the truth, or this is someone just speaking their truth and staying, keeping their nose to their work. Like, cutting out people, places, and things that don't serve them. This is like someone who's determined. So whoever's moving on from this situation, whether it's you or an ex, there's someone here who's very determined. They're keeping their nose in their work. They're very focused on their work, their craft, their skills, and they're blocking out any disruptions that could disrupt them from where it is that they're trying to go. And that's forward with the Chariot. Yeah, someone's ignoring someone. Someone may be spying. Show me this love triangle. What's up with this? Justice. Libra energy is here. Love triangle. The Empress. I can't put an Empress in a love triangle. What the hell? What the hell is wrong with you? Okay, Taurus, Libra. Strong Libra energy is here. Love triangle. Someone here is about to get justice. Something's going to be made fair. Someone's going to have a lot of, you know, fertility, abundance, growth around them. Okay. The Empress knows her worth. This is also someone who's very fair and just. King of Pentacles. Ooh. Well. Okay. I don't know what this has to do with love triangle. Either there was some type of third party situation, but the Empress or Emperor, man or woman, whoever you are, whoever was put into a third party, I feel like they disconnected because they know their worth. Whoever did do the right thing in a situation and, you know, is going to get justice. And there's someone new who's going to come in, who's going to invest into you, man or woman, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn energy. Or you could be planting seeds with someone new who is loyal, who is committed. What's this King of Pentacles doing? Let me make sure. Let me make sure. The Death card. This could be a Scorpio. What else is this King of Pentacles doing? Death card. Could be going through an ending themselves, or there's some type of a spiritual transformation taking place. Two of Swords. Okay. Alright, so I was kind of feeling that, and that's why I wanted to clarify. What's the Seven of Pentacles, Spirit? This is Seven of Pentacles. This is, I feel like this King of Pentacles isn't someone new. I feel like this person could have been the one that had divided loyalties, or man or woman. Maybe someone here didn't see an ending coming, but ultimately I feel like this King of Pentacles may have already been committed or invested into something. And yeah, that's the need one more. Two of Cups in the reverse. So, okay. So maybe this person was going through an ending. Six of Swords, High Priestess. I I don't feel like someone said that, though. Somebody maybe wanting to tell the truth about a situation that they were invested into, but I feel like they did it. They disclosed this. They disclosed this information, and now... So, is this the same person? Anyways, I don't know. For all of you guys, it's going to be different. Somebody who may have put somebody in a love triangle, maybe they were going through an ending where there was disharmony in a relationship. There could have been, you know, unreconcilable differences or something to that nature. Someone here had divided loyalties. Somebody could have been... Someone disclosed the truth about something. What's this Empress doing besides getting justice? Because I did see the Emperor, Six of Swords, High Priestess, Ace of Wands, Eight of Wands. What is the Ace of Wands? Starting something new. Yeah, the Fool card, Six of Wands. Ooh, Seven of Swords. This Empress is starting something new. This could be the same person who's idolized, loved, respected, whatever. Six of Wands, someone who, you know, may do something in the community, have a high social following, or could do something online. There's some type of public recognition, victory. This could be someone graduating school, okay? She could be the one traveling. Did I say that? Anyways, Seven of Swords. Okay, so I'm just going to say my thoughts. Someone here could be lying to the community about this, whoever this Empress is. There could be... fishing for comments. Yeah, someone could be sneaking around someone's socials. If you have those, not everybody does, but I'm just naming what I see here. Show me the Seven of Swords. Okay. Seven of Swords, Nine of Pentacles. Someone here lied about being single. Someone here is strategizing how to become single. Whoever this Empress is, I feel like she's single, stable, self-sufficient, good on her own. Man or woman. Men, this could be you too. Okay? You're someone who's good on your own. You don't need nobody. And I feel like someone was sneaking and they got exposed and you started something new. Nine of Pentacles, Ten of Pentacles. Damn. Someone could have been in a whole fucking commitment, a whole marriage, had a whole family out here. Who's creeping? Sun card, Leo energy. Whoever's creeping is going to get exposed. Someone who's stressed out, losing sleep, up in their head. The Emperor, the Sun, Aries, energy, Six of Cups. Damn, is this your person? Person is creeping and lurking. Maybe this... I'm trying to see this in another way. You know, this Empress could have even lied about being single. She could have been in a whole marriage to this Emperor. And this emperor could have went creeping and found out that there was this King of Pentacles guy over here. Maybe she said she ended it. I don't know who did what here. Pisces, Pisces, Pisces. I got an emperor and an empress in the upright though. And a king. I got everybody in the upright. It doesn't even matter. So who's doing what? I don't know who's doing what. Maybe someone's emperor is going to come in. It's going to make someone extremely happy. Or someone's coming in to heal a situation, take charge of a situation. Why they creeping? Why they creeping, huh? Don't be creepy. Why are you creeping? The Five of Pentacles in the reverse. So, Ten of Cups on the bottom. Damn, Four of Wands. Okay. Someone here feels like they missed an opportunity. Someone here feels like they missed an opportunity. Or the wish fulfillment. Someone wants to come in and fight for some type of a marriage, recover a situation, if there was any type of abandonment, financial struggle. Someone's ready to take charge of a situation, to heal a situation. I don't know where the hell I'm going with this, but I feel like someone was juggling someone in the past. I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now. Took me to places I've never been. Alright. Pisces, you got your hands full, honey. Honey, sir. I did say something in the beginning about some type of a soul contract here. Gosh. It's almost like complete, like, I don't know if I'm just picking up on different groups of Pisces, because some of y'all, you got the Five of Pentacles in the reverse, the Eight of Cups in the reverse, the Two of Cups in reverse. So, Justice in the upright. I'm almost wondering if somebody's like wanting to come in and like, we did a reading about this yesterday, I think. Like someone trying to right wrongs. What's this Seven of Swords? I feel like there's something that I'm not. Three Cups. Someone here just straight up like lied and manipulated a situation. Like some type of a third party situation. I don't know who did what. But I do see like divine counterparts here. I needed a reason. Who's this Eight of Cups in the reverse? I don't know what to tell you guys. I hate it when I can't, like, get you guys, like, a straight up, like, answer. It drives me fucking batshit crazy. Could be an Aries, Leo, Sag coming back in. Eight of Cups, Queen of Swords, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, strong Sag. Someone is coming in to, like, heal a situation, to speak some type of truth, to have some type of new beginning. So, and I was kind of getting that over here. It's like someone needs to speak some type of truth if they want the disharmony within a soulmate connection to go away. Like, I mean, I don't know if it'll necessarily go away. For some of you guys, it won't, but and I see someone who's, like, lost hope that something can be healed. And it's, like, almost like when somebody's, like, not doing something anymore, somebody's, like, wanting to come in and, like, okay, I'll tell you the truth now so I can fix this. But it's, like, that was your last fucking option. That was your last option. Was to tell the truth? Really? Who the fuck would want that? I don't know, I wouldn't. All right, let me get some advice for Pisces, please. So I can close this readout. I don't know what to tell y'all. Someone's going to come in extremely romantic, freaking charming, because I feel like they don't want some cycle to end. They don't want this to be over, but I feel like whoever's moving on, that feels like it's over. It's done. It's already done. And then you got somebody coming in wanting to fight for you. Devil, Nine of Wands. Or you're doing this to someone. Something's going on here. I don't know. You know, oh. So this Empress energy, I don't know if this is someone who works in the justice system or this is just someone who's very fair, giving, balanced, patient, loyal, you know, she's all that in a bag of chips. She's an Empress. Someone may have started something new or jumped into something very quickly. Full card, Ace of Wands, Eight of Wands. Jumped into something very quickly for some type of success. But it was like someone was doing something shady or sneaky or lying. I don't know if they were lying to this woman or this woman was lying to somebody. Like somebody may have gotten into a situation. Dude, I just read about this. And now I'm not saying who did what, whatever. I don't care. But Emperor and the Five of Pentacles in the reverse, the Sun card. I feel like someone did something. Someone jumped into a situation with either someone who was financially well off, stable, okay, for false reasons. Seven of Swords, because I just can't figure out why that Three of Damn Swords or that Seven of Swords is there. With the Six of Wands, Three of Cups, it's like some type of victory. It's like, and that's because whoever this, but damn, they're counterparts. Emperor to Empress, or maybe they're just both, maybe they're mother fathers. I don't know, y'all. Maybe this man has some type of position of authority. Maybe this is an older man. There's so many descriptions, you know, of the Emperor or the Empress. So even if they're not necessarily divine counterparts, or even a divine masculine, this could just be someone who's like a father, you know, or this could be someone who, maybe he's a business owner. Maybe he runs a company. But, you know, could be anything. But there's some type of a recovery, a financial recovery here. So maybe you got with this extremely successful Six of Wands, all the shit up here. This extremely successful, independent woman who was just, I don't know where you place yourself. Okay, I'm done. That could be the Seven of Pentacles, King of Pentacles, too. It's like someone may have invested into something for, like, the stability here. And maybe they want to tell the truth that, hey, this isn't, like, I'm not in love with you, or we just don't see eye to eye, or we're not compatible or something. Like somebody may be saying the truth or even realizing the truth, like, hey, I don't even love this person, or I don't love you, or and someone else may not have seen this ending coming or something. I don't know. All right, let's get three cards of advice for Pisces. We got romance. Oh my. And reconsider. Reconsider. Let go. Let go. Don't stop and reconsider. So some of you guys are going to just straight up let this shit go. I do see someone being romance. There is romance here for sure. But some of you may actually reconsider this once you know the truth, get the truth, say the truth, speak your truth. I don't know. Others of you guys are just going to let go. There can also be someone who's letting go of a situation because they want romance. Like they want love, not, you know, whatever. They may be reconsidering their choices. Two of Swords. They may have had rose-colored glasses on, or they weren't seeing something clearly now. There's some type of a change, a spiritual transformation. I don't know. Maybe somebody's going through a spiritual transformation where they weren't seeing something clearly here. And now they're seeing something clearly, like, yo, this isn't love. Damn, that's like talking about that Mercury retrograde shit that I was talking about. It's like you wake up and you're like, why am I even... why? Okay, so I'm going to leave this reading here. If it resonates, let me know. Smash that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, and I shall see you in the next one. Deuces.